Multimedia, Acción Empresarial, presenta Gerencia para Todos, con Rafael Nieves.
De Gerencia para Todos, dando continuidad a la cobertura que estamos dando al evento del Centro de Arbitraje de la Cámara de Comercio de Caracas, referida al arbitraje mundial. En esta oportunidad vamos a conversar con el doctor Christopher Tabás, quien es socio de la firma de abogados DB Boyce and Plimpton. Bienvenido, doctor Tabás.
Thank you very much.
Welcome to Venezuela.
Thank you.
The first question is, what are the main advantages of the arbitration?
Well, arbitration is a consensual dispute resolution process where two parties can agree on the rules that will be used to govern the resolution of their dispute. One of the main advantages of the arbitration, besides that, is that it results in a decision that can be enforced in multiple countries, unlike the decisions of courts, where it is often difficult to go from one country to another and enforce a decision. Arbitral decisions as a result of an international treaty called the New York Convention can be enforced in a number of jurisdictions around the country.
Why the global business community are favoring the alternative dispute resolution methods with this method, for example, mediation or arbitration? Is there a difference between mediation and arbitration?
There is a difference. Mediation is a more consensual, less formal form of dispute resolution. Arbitration is more formal and actually results in a decision that favors one party and disfavors another party. But international business increasingly is coming to embrace arbitration because when it is done right, it can be fast, it can be very efficient, it is more in the party's control. It doesn't require any party to be in the courts of a country that are familiar with the legal system. As I said, it yields a result that can be enforced in a number of different countries. So it has a number of advantages over traditional litigation in national courts.
According to your experience, what expectations have the user for arbitration process? What is the process?
Well, the expectation of the users is that it will be a more streamlined form of resolving disputes than going to court. So it will take less time. Both sides will be able to have some say in choosing who decides the disputes. Unlike when you go to court and a judge is assigned to you, the parties actually have some input into who the arbitrators are. They have some say into what the process looks like. They expect to be able to fully present their case to the decision maker, and then to have a decision that is rendered quickly and then is fair.
How do we keep the arbitration service at pace with the development of information technology?
Well, that's a very good question, especially with the increased use of email and computer data. It is important for arbitration to keep in mind that all of this data can be very useful, but that if too much emphasis is placed on incorporating every piece of information the arbitration process, then it becomes too expensive and too cumbersome, and some of the advantages of arbitration are lost. So it's a balance between making good use of the technology but not becoming too focused on the technology.
Which are the main challenges for the development of international arbitration today?
As disputes become more complicated, more international, as there's more technology, the main challenges of arbitration are to continue to make the process fast and efficient and user-friendly so that users will get all the benefits that they expect to get out of the process.
Well, Dr. Tabás, thank you for this interview.
Thank you very much for having me.
For your information.
pleasure talking to you.